is a song that I didn't really want to write. We were in the studio and we needed another song for the album, for the last album, which, by the way, we have for sale over here. So I had to go to a little retreat with a small church up in northeastern Ohio, and I thought, oh, great. We're right in the middle of, here I am in a big, important recording star and a big, important recording studio in Nashville with a big recording contract, and I'm going to some church, spend a weekend with about 10 kids, and this isn't going to be any fun. And I was working on this song, couldn't get it finished, and so we got up to the retreat, and I started talking to this kid. Late one night, he wanted to talk to me, and I started talking to him, and it got later and later and later, and as time went by, I found out that he had shot himself in the stomach about 6 months before. And he talked a lot about the depression and the despair, about how he had nothing to hope for, that he didn't believe there was any way out, and just how desperate he had gotten until he had tried to kill himself, and then the humiliation of failing at that suicide attempt. So I had the music for this song all written, and I realized at that time that this should be a song for him. So this is a song for people who shoot themselves in the stomach, also called On the Verge of a Miracle. Reviews that you get in magazines by people who don't have a clue as to what's going on. Not that I think I get necessarily bad reviews, I just think they criticize the wrong things about my albums. This guy said that this was a morose song because it dealt with death. And he said the rest of these songs are pretty nice on this album, but this one is really morose and it's kind of maudlin and it's about dying. You know, I think it's a bizarre thing that in the first century, Christians looked at death with a great anticipation. And that in primitive Christianity, death was considered a wonderful time. That in the Old Testament, it says that we should celebrate the day of a man's funeral and not the day of his birth. And yet in sophisticated 20th century America, we look at all those church traditions and the wisdom of God, and we scoff at it, and we say people who want to die are morbid. I don't particularly want to die because my life is bad, because I have probably the best life in the world. I don't have to work for a living or anything. When I left the farm, I grew up on a farm, and when I left, I said, God, do anything, but don't let me work. If I never pull another weed, if I never swing another hoe or throw another bale of hay, it'll be all the same to me. About 10 years later, I bought a few acres of land. Well, I bought it in Tennessee because Tennessee is so beautiful. But you know what? Man, there is nothing more beautiful than the mountains around here. They just knock me out. So I wrote this song in eastern Tennessee because I was looking at the mountains there, and they're also very beautiful, and I was thinking about how awful they would look if somebody really did drop the bomb, and how that eventually God was going to burn those mountains up anyway, and that if it would make some commie happy, then they should go ahead and do it. because eventually we will judge the nations, and I've got my favorites picked out. Everybody, each and all, we're gonna die eventually. This no more or less our fault than it is our destinies. So now, Lord, I come to you asking only for your grace. You know what I put myself through, all those empty dreams I chased.
Chosen, that if you were elected, I believe that if God has anything for you, it's not just to make you happy. God did not choose you and call you out of this world just to make you high. And God didn't choose you and God didn't call you out of this world just so that you could be pious. Because there are enough pious people and there are enough happy people in the world. What God called you for and what God called you to is to make a difference in the world. You know, there are a lot of people who have never heard the gospel of Christ. And somehow I have a little bit of trouble sometimes when I see people spending 15, 16 bucks a hit to hear some flashy Christian group say Jesus is Lord to the tune of 15 bucks a person. When there are people who live not far from here who can't even afford to buy a Bible. And somehow it seems a little bit weird that we should have more ministers in this country and fewer people, when in the world where there are so many people who would give anything to have a minister, they can't find them because they're not there, because they're in our country. I don't believe that God chose you and blessed you so that you could heap those blessings up upon yourself. I believe God chose you and you and you and every one of you others because he wants to make a difference in this world. And you know what? What I think is scary about God is he didn't come up with any plan B. That he left the church here, and the church is the only group of people, and the church is the only institution in the world that can bring about a change. This government cannot do it. So stop depending on the government. Educational systems cannot do it, so stop trusting educational systems. The church was chosen by God to make a difference. And you know what, people? You ain't going to make a difference by building more bombs. And you ain't going to make a difference by putting on more makeup and showing up on more television shows. And you're not going to make a difference by having the loudest PA or the biggest crowd at your concerts. You're going to make a difference when you lay down your life and in complete submission to God, choose to die with him in service to other people. And I had this great realization one night, and that's when I wrote this song. This laid me down one evening, the thought of Jesus on the hill. Just allow. None of
This guitar is like terminally out of tune, but I don't know how to tune it. And I'm a big believer that things are boring if they're really fine. You just really have to excuse these chords. It's just a song about old friends. Gonna be on an album that will be out in February, and it's called Rich Mullins Pictures in the Sky. And I'd sure appreciate it if you buy a whole lot of copies for all your relatives. This is a song that I wrote just about being short. I'm gonna tell you a story.